What's good, y'all, and welcome back to another episode of Just Drippin', my style and fashion segment here on my channel. And today, I thought I would do a little video I would like to call my Tattoo Testaments. This video was inspired by a YouTuber whom I follow named Richie Lee, based out of Seattle. Shout out to you, Richie. Richie recently talked about his own experience with getting his two full sleeve tattoos. And for me, I recently got a little half sleeve, you could say. So I would like to talk about my own experience on this video with y'all. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. Also, I want to give a huge shout out to my artist Charlie Compa out of Vancouver, Washington. He tattoos over at STS Inc. I'll put the Instagram page of his or the tattoo shop right here. Go check it out. He did both of my pieces for the rose and the bamboo. Go check him out. I really love his style with the fact that it's, you know, just the black ink, nothing too fancy, but still has a really clean overall look to it. Thank you again, Charlie. Shout out to you. Now let's get right into the video. All right, to start things off, I have a few questions that I got from my Instagram followers about my experience with getting tattoos. The first question that I have is, did it hurt? I'll be honest, it kind of depends where you get your tattoo. For me personally, the forearm where I got my rose, this was my first tattoo. This one didn't hurt too bad, just because on my forearm, I still have some, believe it or not, I still have some muscle and fat right here. So that wasn't too bad for me. On the other hand, on the other part of my forearm, as you can see, it's skinnier. And you can see right here the bone, right here on top, and then right there on the bottom. Those parts definitely hurt the most. But it's especially right here when my artist got towards the elbow. But in my opinion, the part that hurts the most isn't when the artist is drawing out the actual design. It's when the artist is doing in all the shading and giving those really fine details into the design of the tattoo. Like for example, with me, you can see the different black shades and all the detail where they're at in the tattoo. So for me, it was the shading that hurt the most. But overall, it's not too bad. If you really want a tattoo, you just have to suck it up. And it's temporary pain, to be honest. Next question. This isn't word for word, but basically the question is saying, what did your dad think about you getting tattoos, especially in a Filipino household? For those of you that don't know, in Filipino culture and many other Asian cultures, tattoos kind of have a bad rep because they're not necessarily, I don't want to say frowned upon or not accepted, but they kind of go against the status quo of those cultural societies, if that makes sense. You know, they think in those cultures that if you have a tattoo, you're a criminal, you're a gangster, you've been to prison, those kinds of stereotypes and thoughts. But obviously, to many, tattoo is really an art form, and it's none of those things that I just mentioned. Thankfully, my dad, he was cool with it, with me getting tattoos. To be honest, I would not have gotten these tattoos if he didn't give me the approval. And it's a quick side story, my dad actually had a tattoo when he was younger on his hand, but he had it removed. So I feel that as I grew older, he saw, met me eye to eye on that, and we were able to go from there. So I'm just thankful that I have a very, you know, loving and accepting parent. And the last question that I have, do you want to get more tattoos or are you good with just two? Ooh, to be honest, I would like to get a full sleeve. I would like to get more up here in the upper arm. And it's kind of true what they say, that once you get one tattoo, you're going to want to get more despite all of the pain that you're going to have to go through physically. But in my opinion, it's worth it, especially because for me, with my pieces, each of them have meaning and they're going to keep having meaning as I keep going. So overall, I would like the whole sleeve to kind of be a whole puzzle of smaller puzzle pieces, if that makes sense. So would I keep going more than just two? Yes, definitely. Moving along from the questions to my advice for y'all when it comes to getting your tattoos before, during, and after your sessions. Before, do your research. Figure out what design you want to get, what style you want to get it in, what kind of artist you want to work with, how much are you willing to pay for your tattoo. Think of those type of questions because really, aside from being a work of art that's going to be on your skin, that's going to be permanent, and that's going to be on you for the rest of your life, a tattoo is an investment. You're going to put money down. You're going to get it. It's almost like a car, for example. It's an investment, and it's going to be with you for a long time. So do your research when it comes to all of that stuff. And also, before your sessions too, be sure once you find the artist you want to work with, make sure you have a good relationship with them. Make sure that they are an artist that you would like to work with closely, especially an artist who can give you exactly what you want, but who can also balance in their own artistic style into the tattoo that you're getting. Don't be afraid to trust the process and trust the artist. They've been doing that stuff for a long time. So when you find the right artist, a good artist, trust me, you will be in good hands. During your tattoo sessions, two main things. Make sure you are hydrated. Make sure you eat beforehand. You're gonna be sitting there for a while, sometimes in one position like this, the whole time while you're getting tatted and you're just sitting there. So it would be really bad if you, for whatever reason, in the middle of your session, you feel lightheaded or you don't feel well, or maybe you feel super thirsty and you need some water. You know, having the proper amount of hydration is going to help, you know, the process of getting tattooed easier. From what I've heard and from what I experienced, the more that you're hydrated, you know, the more that the blood can flow easier as the ink and the work starts mixing in and everything is happening. With that, do not drink alcohol. I want to say maybe two to three days beforehand, and even the day before. Don't have any alcohol or any drugs in your system, because the alcohol will thin out your blood when you're getting tattooed, and that's just not good to have. And lastly, after your sessions, make sure that you have all the proper things you need to have in order to maintain your tattoo and care for it as it heals. If you're not sure what that entails, please, please, please don't be afraid to ask the artist you just work with what soap you need to be using when cleaning it, what lotion you need to keep it from being dry, you know, stuff like that. And they are there, they put their art on you, and as much as possible, out of respect for them and for you and the piece, you know, take care of the art. So take care of it. Don't be afraid to ask questions. Don't be afraid to just work and trust with your artist. That pretty much wraps it up for this Tattoo Testaments video. Also, very special announcement. I came out with my own clothing brand. As you can see, I'm rocking a shirt right now. The JD Duran Collection, officially available. Please check out JD Duran Collection on Instagram. I'll put the link or the username right here. Go check that out. I'm super, super excited to start this new journey, and hopefully y'all can rock with me through this. I would love to see it grow, just like the rose and the bamboo. Growth, I'm a big person of growth. I'm all for it. So yeah, I'm just super excited and super blessed. Thank y'all for helping me make not only my channel, my clothing brand, but also me into the person that I am today. Lastly, what kind of tattoo would y'all like to get if it weren't an issue, if you weren't worried about pain, cost? What kind of tattoo design would y'all get? I'm curious. Leave your answers down in the comment section below. More videos to come for sure. More clothing items to come in the future. Until next time, y'all, stay fresh and stay blessed. Peace.